I've been like, I'm always reevaluating things and analyzing my life and, you know what I'm saying, my personal goals and, you know, looking at where I came from, where I am now type thing. And I had a moment earlier today while I was listening to some motivational music. Check out SoundCloud. Anyway, I was listening to some motivational music, and I just started thinking about where I am now. Like, my goal used to be, like, just get through the day. Get through the day without having an episode, without crying, without, you know, letting my mind go into that dark place. Avoiding so many things that needed to be worked through. And now it's like, my goal is to touch as many lives and as many hearts as I possibly can just through my experience, through my growth. Like, where I was and where I am now says so much about what I've done and what I've been doing to get to where I am right now. And it's always a message of hope, always. Like, for the simple fact that all you got to do is just keep going. All you got to do is do your best. And sometimes your best may be the smallest, simplest thing ever. And that may be just getting out of the bed. And that's a success. That's a successful move for you. And that's what it's all about. Baby steps. This was a struggle for me at one point. Just getting out of bed. Just getting dressed, just going to work. A lot of things were so hard to do. Now it's getting better, and it's getting better. And as long as I keep working at it, it will get better. And things don't get easier, you get stronger. And I really want to pinpoint that. Things do not get easier in life, you get stronger, so things don't bother you as much. And, you know, if you working on things, and you know what I'm saying, like therapy, like writing, like digging deep into the things that you love, that's a big tool. Like digging deep into the things that you love, whether that be writing, whether that be painting, whether that be dancing, you know, anything, whether that be even like volunteering, something like that. Like, it could be anything that you love doing that makes you feel good. And I understand, like, when you're depressed, it's hard to do the things that you love doing. And that's the thing about depression. You always want to do the opposite of how you feel. And it's hard. Nothing that's worth having is going to be easy if you want it bad enough, though. Like, my motivation is, I ain't want to go back to nobody's hospital, and I ain't want to be on nobody's meds no more. Now, today, I can say that I safely got off of the medication with the approval of the psychiatrist. Please be careful with these medications. Do not get off of them on your own. Let them know that your goal is to get off of them eventually. And you know what I'm saying? Like, with some, you can wean yourself off, but make sure you keep in connection with your therapist and your psychiatrist so they know the steps that you're taking. And they want to know, and they want to be sure that you are taking the proper steps to, you know, have more control and balance of your emotions and your thoughts, and make sure that you're sleeping, because they have a medication for every issue that you have. And part of getting past those things is self-mastery, like doing whatever I have to do not to get, you know what I'm saying, back on meds, or, you know, back in the hospital. Like, that is not what I want. And so I made it a point to make peace with my thoughts, you know, to keep going to therapy. That is a main goal, like one of the main goals, like keep going to therapy and work through these things that I've had so many hard times getting through and avoiding. Like, the more you avoid these issues that you have within yourself and that you have a hard time facing, the more they're going to keep reappearing into your life until you deal with them. It's almost like you have to shake hands with this pain and say, okay, let's deal with this together. And that's basically how it is. Like, it's crazy how, you know, the growth, just thinking about my own growth is amazing. And like, it's so many people out there who have that growth, you know what I'm saying, who came from this space and now have elevated to a new, you know what I'm saying, a new higher place. And that's what's up. Like, I don't want to keep thinking about mental disabilities and mental illnesses as disabilities and illnesses. I don't want to think about that anymore, because it doesn't make me feel good about myself at all, for one. And it has all of these limitations. Like, we are infinite creatures and this is limiting my ability. Like, no, this ain't me, and it's not you either. We are at a time in our lives where we have a hard time working through and processing through whatever we're going through. But it's not over. It's not done. You're doing exactly what you need to be doing to get better, to feel better about yourself and about the situations around you. But it starts with self. Self changes everything around you. It changes everything around you. And the better relation that you have with your mind and your body and spirit, like, the better relationship that you have with self, the better your relationship and your environment changes. And it's crazy how it happens, but that is the kingdom of heaven. Love, peace, like, this is heaven. You understand? Anyway, thank you for listening. Thank y'all for following me through this journey. It's not over. We're going to keep rising. We're going to keep climbing together. I fell for a reason. We fall for a reason. But when you come back up, you bring people with you. And that's what I'm on. Touch lives, hearts. Yes, I shall.